Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time here, you are highly welcome. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel after watching this video if you have not done so already. And when you subscribe, you click on the bell sign. The bell gives you instant notification whenever I upload a new video. So guys, this soup is just simple but delicious recipe that we are going to be making for today. This soup, you can enjoy it with any swallow of your choice. So if you are interested, keep watching. But before we start making this soup guys, we need to go to the garden to get some okra for the recipe. So guys, as you can see, this is my okra. Time for harvest. See how fresh that okra is looking like. So guys, as you can see, we are here now to get our okra. That okra is so fresh and is looking forward to come and get it and start eating. So I'm just going to start cutting the okra out from the stem. I will start taking it one after the other, one after the other. And this is how the okra is looking like, guys. So fresh and so long. When I'm done getting on this very side, I will head over to the other side and start getting the okra as much as I can or as I want for this recipe. So guys, when I'm done getting all the okra, as you can see, if you are familiar to this channel, you know that I have a garden. This is my bitter leaf. We have a very severe weather in our city, and this is what the severe weather caused for me. The wind, we have hurricane, Dorian hurricane. So yeah, this is what the hurricane did to my bitter leaf. He rooted the bitter leaf down. But guys, I'm super duper happy because this Dorian hurricane killed so many people, rendered so many people homeless. What is bitter leaf compared to someone's life? So guys, like I said, I'm super duper happy that it's just bitter leaf. So over there, I was just trying to see if I can fix the root of the bitter leaf back to its normal position, but as you can see, it was not able to stand. So I just left it, and when hubby comes, he will use a manpower to stand it for me. So let's head over to the kitchen. As you can see guys, this is the okra. This okra is so fresh and so long. I'm super proud of myself. So guys, I'm just going to start cutting the okra. I told you guys before that my husband does not like seeing okra in his soup, as he doesn't like big chunk of okra. So I'm just going to cut some, then I will blend some. Guys, I find it fun cutting my okra with hands, to be honest with you. I love cutting okra by hands. So I will start by cutting the okra as much as I can. When I'm done cutting it, as you guys can see, I'm just going to set it aside. Then I will crush some on my food processor. If you want, you can cut by hands. If you want, you can crush. You know, choose whatsoever that works for you or whatever your family loves. So I'm just going to crush it. When I'm done crushing it guys, I'm going to take it out from the blender, then I'll transfer it on this plate, as you can see. So I went ahead and added some red onions and some colors of bell peppers. Guys, this is just an optional, you mustn't do this, but if you like it, you can as well do it. I just love the color of the pepper inside the okra, that was why I did it. You know. So as you can see, this is how the crushed one is looking, and this is the one I cut by hands. So guys, when I went to the garden to get the okra, I was cooking the meat already. We are using oyster for today's recipe. Yes, oyster meat tastes so good. So this is my oyster, well cooked and well garnished. And I added some crabs as well. In the meat there, I just used the onions. I blended some colors of bell peppers and the cubes and salt. I love keeping my meat very simple whenever I'm making my soup, because I don't want the soup to turn out tasting somehow, you know. So guys, I discovered that that pot was so small, so I have to transfer it on a bigger pot. So when I'm done transferring it, I just added the crayfish and some crabs that I cracked out. I'm going to add a tablespoon of powdered cube. When I'm done adding it guys, I'm just going to push it around, or you know, stir it up a little bit. You guys already know the reason why I cracked the crab. If you know, let me know in the comment section below. So I added some palm oil. When I'm done adding the palm oil, guys, I'm just going to cover it and allow the soup to start cooking. After some minutes of cooking, guys, this is our soup. It's looking yummy already, right? I'm just going to stir it. When I'm done, I'm going to add the crushed okra that I mixed with the bell peppers and onions. Then I'll now add the one I cut with my hands. I'm just going to stir it appropriately. Mix it very well so that everything inside that soup will touch each other. Let them communicate. Let them know that there are brothers and sisters inside that soup. Don't mind me, guys. I'm just so happy making this video, to be honest with you. Are you seeing the color of that soup? Is it not giving you life? So like I say, stir it very well. When I'm done stirring it, guys, I will allow it to cook for like 2 minutes because I don't want the okra to be overcooked. Okay, you know, this is vegetable, you don't want it to be overcooked, because even when you bring it down, the heat from the pot will continue cooking the soup. So as you can see, the okra is slimy to my taste. So at this point, guys, I added my frozen mushroom. This is frozen mushroom. I store this mushroom myself, that is why it's looking like that. So when I'm done adding it, guys, I'm just going to cover it up again so that it will cook for like some seconds, you know. Like I said, you don't want to overcook your okra. After some seconds, guys, I added my bitter leaf. I washed this bitter leaf myself as well. If you have bitter leaf, you can use it for your okra. But if you don't have bitter leaf, guys, you can make do with any vegetable of your choice. So guys, what I did not show you guys in this video is that I added a spinach off camera. Yes, I added a little bit of spinach. Guys, it's just optional. If you want, you can use just spinach. If you want, you can use bitter leaf, you know. Like I said, any vegetable will be fine for this recipe. So guys, I will just go ahead and mix it up very well. If you have fish, you can as well add it at this point, you know. When I'm done mixing it, I'm just going to cover it up and allow to simmer for some seconds. So guys, after some seconds later, our soup is as good as done. Look at that soup, guys. Is it not calling your name? So guys, I paired this soup with potato fufu. Like I said, you can enjoy it with any swallow of your choice. You can eat it just the way it is. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video, and please, if you like the video, do not forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you have not subscribed to this channel, what are you waiting for? Subscribe and join this beautiful family. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in my next video. Until then, keep loving yourself.